Yes, in today's session, let us see the ethical issues in biotechnology. So genetic engineering, it is having many beneficial properties, or we can say many of the products can be extracted or produced through the genetic engineering, as well as different organisms are produced, genetically modified organisms, or we say it as a transgenic organisms. It may be transgenic animals or transgenic plants such as BT plants. So many of the applications in the field of drug production, production of insulin. So like this, it is having many of the what benefits. But meanwhile, sometimes the genetic engineering, it may be harmful also. It may produce some of the harmful effects also if it is manipulated wrongly. Okay. If it is what manipulated wrongly, then it may produce what harmful effects also. So that's why for the proper regulation, there should be a one particular committee. So that's why the Indian government, it has a set up one organization known as a Genetic Engineering Approval Committee. So this committee, this Genetic Engineering Approval Committee, it regulates approval committee. So it is having control over the these researchers, especially the production of genetically modified organisms, because these genetically modified organisms, when it is released in the ecosystem or when it is released into the market or the ecosystem, it should not produce any type of imbalance in the nature. Environmental release maadidaga, it should not produce what imbalance in the nature, or it should not affect the food chain in the ecosystem. Okay, so these are the reasons. And sometimes the production of genetically modified organisms, it may produce harmful effect. Instead of what production of drugs, etc., sometimes it may produce different diseases. Okay, so that's why there should be a particular regulation is needed. So this committee, Genetically Engineering Approval Committee, it is created by organized by Government of India in association with the Ministry of Environment and Forest. So it will regulate these decisions, such as it will take decisions regarding the validity of genetically modified research. So particular research, it should be what valid up to a particular period of time. Then approval for a large scale manufacturing, the production of certain drugs. Okay, in such condition they require approval from this particular committee. Okay, then similarly, environmental release of genetically altered organism. The genetically altered organisms, when it is released in the nature or in the what environment, it should not produce a harmful effect. So that's why for that also, what the permission or authorization is needed. Okay, because certain times what happens, the production of some of the microbial bombs, so anta kelome, especially in the army, etc., they will use in order to defeat the other countries. So anta condition kuda irbodu kelome. Then production of clones. Okay, you must have seen the example of Saddam Hussein, etc. So alli enayitu anta helidre, the clones were produced. So many people, they were what having similar appearance. So it was through what genetic engineering, ee tara clone production maduvantaddu. Okay, if it is production of clone, in the sense the production of Nancy, Rosie, cow, so that the there also we are producing clones, but alli eno for ಒಪ್ಟೈನಿಂಗ್ ಡಿಫ್ರೆಂಟ್ ಪ್ರಾಡಕ್ಟ್ಸಿಗೆ ಬೇಕಾಗಿ ಕ್ಲೋನನ್ನು ಪ್ರೊಡಕ್ಷನ್ ಮಾಡುವಂಥದ್ದು. ಬಟ್ ಸಮ್ಟೈಮ್ಸ್ ಹ್ಯೂಮನ್ ಕ್ಲೋನ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ಪ್ರೊಡ್ಯೂಸ್, ಸೊ ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಅ ವೆರಿ ಡೇಂಜರಸ್. ಓಕೆ, ಸೊ ದ್ಯಾಟ್ಸ್ ವೈ ಸೊ ದೀಸ್ ಎಥಿಕಲ್ ಇಶ್ಯೂಸ್ ವಿಲ್ ಅರೈಸ್. ಹ್ಯೂಮನ್ ಕ್ಲೋನ್ಸ್ ಮಾಡುವಂಥದ್ದು ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಅಗೇನ್ಸ್ಟ್ ದಿ ವಾಟ್ ನೇಚರ್. ಸೊ ನೇಚರಲ್ಲಿ ಯಾವುದೇ ಥರದ ಏನಾಗಬಾರ್ದು, ದೇರ್ ಶುಡ್ ನಾಟ್ ಬಿ ಇಂಬ್ಯಾಲೆನ್ಸ್. ಓಕೆ, ಸೊ ಆ ಥರ. ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಸರ್ಟೇನ್ ಟೈಮ್ಸ್ ದ ಪ್ರೊಡ್ಯೂಸ್ಡ್ ದೀಸ್ ಜೆನೆಟಿಕಲಿ ಮಾಡಿಫೈಡ್ ಆರ್ಗ್ಯಾನಿಸಮ್ಸ್ ದೇ ಮೇ ವಾಟ್ ಕಾಂಪೀಟ್ ವಿತ್ ದ ನ್ಯಾಚುರಲ್ ಆರ್ಗ್ಯಾನಿಸಮ್ಸ್ ವಿಚ್ ಆರ್ ಲಿವಿಂಗ್ ಇನ್ ಅ ಪರ್ಟಿಕ್ಯುಲರ್ ಏರಿಯಾ. ಸೊ ಅಂಥ ಸಂದರ್ಭದಲ್ಲಿ ಏನಾಗ್ತದೆ, ದ ಕಾಂಪಿಟೀಷನ್ ಅಕ್ಕರ್ ಬಿಟ್ವೀನ್ ದಿ ಜೆನೆಟಿಕಲಿ ಮಾಡಿಫೈಡ್ ಆರ್ಗ್ಯಾನಿಸಮ್ ಆಸ್ ವೆಲ್ ಆಸ್ ದ ಆರ್ಗ್ಯಾನಿಸಮ್ ವಿಚ್ ಆರ್ ಪ್ರೆಸೆಂಟ್ ಇನ್ ಅ ಪರ್ಟಿಕ್ಯುಲರ್ ವಾಟ್ ಇಕೋಸಿಸ್ಟಮ್. ಸೊ ಇನ್ ಸಚ್ ಕಂಡೀಷನ್ ದ ಆರ್ಗ್ಯಾನಿಸಮ್ಸ್ ಅರ್ಲಿಯರ್ ವಿಚ್ ವೆರ್ ಪ್ರೆಸೆಂಟ್ ದೇರ್ ದೇ ಮೇ ಬಿಕಮ್ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಟಿಂಕ್ಟ್. ಓಕೆ, ಬಿಕಾಸ್ ಜೆನೆಟಿಕಲಿ ಮಾಡಿಫೈಡ್ ಆರ್ಗ್ಯಾನಿಸಮ್ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ರೆಸಿಸ್ಟೆಂಟ್ ಟು ಡಿಫ್ರೆಂಟ್ ಟೈಪ್ ಆಫ್ ಡಿಸೀಸ್, ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಹ್ಯಾವಿಂಗ್ ರೆಸಿಸ್ಟೆಂಟ್ ಟು ಡಿಫ್ರೆಂಟ್ ಟೈಪ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಎನ್ವೈರ್ಮೆಂಟಲ್ ಕಂಡೀಷನ್ ಎಕ್ಸೆಟ್ರಾ. ಓಕೆ, ಸೊ ಡ್ಯೂ ಟು ದ್ಯಾಟ್ ದ ಆರ್ಗ್ಯಾನಿಸಮ್ ವಿಚ್ ಈಸ್ ಪ್ರೆಸೆಂಟ್ ಇನ್ ದ್ಯಾಟ್ ಪರ್ಟಿಕ್ಯುಲರ್ ಏರಿಯಾ ಇಟ್ ಮೇ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಟಿಂಕ್ಟ್. ಓಕೆ, ಸೊ ಹಾಗೆಲ್ಲ ಆಗಬಾರ್ದು. ಸೊ ದ್ಯಾಟ್ಸ್ ವೈ ಇನ್ ಆರ್ಡರ್ ಟು ಅವಾಯ್ಡ್ ದೀಸ್ ಸಚ್ ಟೈಪ್ ಆಫ್ ಕಂಡೀಷನ್ಸ್ ವಾಟ್ ದಿಸ್ ಕಮಿಟಿ ಆಸ್ ಕ್ರಿಯೇಟೆಡ್. ಸೊ ದ್ಯಾಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಅಬೌಟ್ ದಿ ಎಥಿಕಲ್ ಇಶ್ಯೂಸ್. ಓಕೆ, ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಲೆಟ್ ಅಸ್ ಸೀ ಅಬೌಟ್ ದಿ ಬಯೋ ಪೇಟೆಂಟ್. ಆರ್ ದ ಪೇಟೆಂಟ್, ಲೆಟ್ ಅಸ್ ಸೀ ವಾಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಮೆಂಟ್ ಬೈ ಪೇಟೆಂಟ್. ಪೇಟೆಂಟ್ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಎಸೆನ್ಷಿಯಲಿ ಅ ಕಾಂಟ್ರಾಕ್ಟ್ ಬಿಟ್ವೀನ್ ದಿ ಸೊಸೈಟಿ ಆಸ್ ಅ ಹೋಲ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಆಸ್ ಆನ್ ಇನ್ವೆಂಟರ್. ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಒನ್ ಟೈಪ್ ಆಫ್ ಅ ಕಾಂಟ್ರಾಕ್ಟ್ ಬಿಟ್ವೀನ್ ದ ಹೋಲ್ ಸೊಸೈಟಿ ಆ್ಯಸ್ ವೆಲ್ ಆ್ಯಸ್ ಇನ್ ಬಿಟ್ವೀನ್ ದಿ ಇನ್ವೆಂಟರ್. ಒಬ್ಬ ಇನ್ವೆಂಟರ್ ಇರ್ತಾನೆ ಅಥವಾ ಒಬ್ಬ ಡಿಸ್ಕವರರ್ ಇರ್ತಾನೆ, ಹೀ ಮೇ ಇನ್ವೆಂಟ್ ಪರ್ಟಿಕ್ಯುಲರ್ ಆರ್ಗ್ಯಾನಿಸಮನ್ನು ಇನ್ವೆಂಟ್ ಮಾಡ್ಬೋದು, ಆರ್ ಪರ್ಟಿಕ್ಯುಲರ್ ಥಿಂಗನ್ನು ಇನ್ವೆಂಟ್ ಮಾಡ್ಬೋದು, ಆರ್ ಹೀ ಮೇ ಡಿಸ್ಕವರ್ ಪರ್ಟಿಕ್ಯುಲರ್ ಪ್ರಾಪರ್ಟಿ ಫ್ರಾಮ್ ಅ ಪರ್ಟಿಕ್ಯುಲರ್ ಆರ್ಗ್ಯಾನಿಸಮ್, ಆರ್ ಹೀ ಮೇ ಡಿಸ್ಕವರ್ ಪರ್ಟಿಕ್ಯುಲರ್ ಪ್ರಾಪರ್ಟಿ ಹೌ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಯೂಸ್ಫುಲ್. ಸೊ ಈ ಥರ ಇನ್ವೆಂಟ್ ಮಾಡುವಂಥದ್ದು ಆರ್ ಡಿಸ್ಕವರ್ ಮಾಡುವಂಥದ್ದು. ಓಕೆ, ಸೊ ದ್ಯಾಟ್ ಪರ್ಸನ್ ಈಸ್ ನೋನ್ ಆಸ್ ಇನ್ವೆಂಟರ್. ಓಕೆ, ದೆನ್ ಸೊ ಇನ್ ಬಿಟ್ವೀನ್ ದಿ ಇನ್ವೆಂಟರ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಇನ್ ಬಿಟ್ವೀನ್ ದಿ ಸೊಸೈಟಿ ದೆರ್ ಈಸ್ ಒನ್ ಟೈಪ್ ಆಫ್ ಅ ಕಾಂಟ್ರಾಕ್ಟ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಹೋಲ್ ರೈಟ್ಸ್ ಆಲ್ ದ ರೈಟ್ಸ್ ವೆರ್ ಗಿವನ್ ಟು ದಿ ಇನ್ವೆಂಟರ್. ಇನ್ವೆಂಟರಿಗೆ ಅಥವಾ ಯಾರು ಡಿಸ್ಕವರ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಾರ ಆರ್ ಹೂ ಈಸ್ ಅಪ್ಲಿಕಂಟ್, ಯಾರು ಅದಕ್ಕೆ ಅಪ್ಲೈ ಆಗ್ತಾರೆ, ಇಟ್ ಮೇ ಬಿ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಇಟ್ ಮೇ ಬಿ ಸಿಂಗಲ್ ಪರ್ಸನ್ ಇರ್ಬೋದು ಆರ್ ಇಟ್ ಮೇ ಬಿ ಅ ಕಂಪೆನಿ ಆಲ್ಸೋ. ಓಕೆ, ಸೊ ದ್ಯಾಟ್ ಕಂಪೆನಿ ಆರ್ ದ್ಯಾಟ್ ಪರ್ಸನ್ ಹೀ ಗೆಟ್ಸ್ ಆಲ್ ದ ರೈಟ್ಸ್ ಟು ಸೆಲ್ ದ್ಯಾಟ್ ಪ್ರಾಡಕ್ಟ್. ಓಕೆ, ಆರ್ ಟು ಏನು ಟೇಕಿಂಗ್ ಏನು ಅದರ್ ಡಿಸಿಷನ್ಸ್ ರಿಗಾರ್ಡಿಂಗ್ ದ್ಯಾಟ್ ಪ್ರಾಡಕ್ಟ್, ಹೀ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಫಿಕ್ಸ್ ದ ಪ್ರೈಸ್ ಫಾರ್ ದ್ಯಾಟ್ ಪ್ರಾಡಕ್ಟ್. ಸೊ ಈ ಥರ ಆಲ್ ದ ರೈಟ್ಸ್ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ಗಿವನ್ ಫಾರ್ ಅ ಪೀರಿಯಡ್ ಆಫ್ ಟೈಮ್ ಟು ದ್ಯಾಟ್ ಪರ್ಸನ್ ಆರ್ ಟು ದ್ಯಾಟ್ ಕಂಪೆನಿ. ಸೊ ದ್ಯಾಟ್ ಈಸ್ ನಥಿಂಗ್ ಬಟ್ ದ ಪೇಟೆಂಟ್. ಸೊ ಪೇಟೆಂಟ್ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಎಸೆನ್ಷಿಯಲಿ ಅ ಕಾಂಟ್ರಾಕ್ಟ್ ಬಿಟ್ವೀನ್ ದ ಸೊಸೈಟಿ ಆ್ಯಸ್ ಅ ಹೋಲ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಆ್ಯಸ್ ಆ್ಯನ್ ಇನ್ವೆಂಟರ್. ಓಕೆ, ಲೆಟ್ ಅಸ್ ಸೀ ಪೇಟೆಂಟ್ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಅ ಸೆಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಕ್ಲೂಸಿವ್ ರೈಟ್ಸ್ ಗ್ರ್ಯಾಂಟೆಡ್ ಬೈ ಅ ಗೌರ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ಟು ಆ್ಯನ್ ಇನ್ವೆಂಟರ್ ಆರ್ ಅಪ್ಲಿಕಂಟ್ ಫಾರ್ ಅ ಸರ್ಟೇನ್ ಪೀರಿಯಡ್ ಆಫ್ ಟೈಮ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಪ್ರಿವೆಂಟ್ ಅದರ್ಸ್ ಫ್ರಾಮ್ ಮೇಕಿಂಗ್ ಆರ್ ಯೂಸಿಂಗ್ ಸೆಲ್ಲಿಂಗ್ ಆರ್ ಇಂಪೋರ್ಟಿಂಗ್ ದ ಗಿವನ್ ಇನ್ವೆನ್ಷನ್. ಓಕೆ, ಸೊ ಪೇಟೆಂಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಅ ಸೆಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಕ್ಲೂಸಿವ್ ರೈಟ್ಸ್ granted by a government government to an inventor or applicant for a certain period of time prevents the others, and it prevents the others to buying or selling or importing and using that particular invention. Okay, so that is nothing but the patent. So it is a set of exclusive rights granted by the government to an inventor or applicant. An inventor may be a single person, or inventor may be as a whole company, okay, for a certain period of time, and it prevents the others from making, others they cannot make that particular product, and they cannot use that particular without the permission of this company, and they cannot sell again without this without the permission of this company or the inventor, and they cannot import also this particular invention. Aa invention annu en madlik aagudilla, import kuda madlik aagudilla. Okay, so we'll see certain examples. So for example, rice. So rice, it is our, in India rice is a main what food. About 2 lakhs of varieties of rice are present all over the India, and it is a main food in India. Again, in rice varieties, one of the rice variety, that is basmati, you must know about the basmati. Different variety, again in basmati also there are about 27 varieties are there. Different varieties. Okay, so basmati rice, it is a bit, the grains are longer one, then having good aroma, adakondu flavor irthade, smell irthade, aroma irthade. Okay, so that is a basmati rice. So this basmati rice, it was got patented from one of the US company known as a Rice Tech helvanta company. It got the patent for the basmati rice in the year 1997, the company known as Rice Tech. So American company or US company. It got a patent for a basmati rice. What they did means, they crossed the, this company crossed the basmati rice with the semi dwarf variety of a rice. Semi dwarf variety of rice, and they got what? New variety. New basmati variety was obtained. And what they did, they said that this invention, it belongs to them, or this new variety of basmati, it belongs to them, it is their invention. And they started, they got the patent for that, and they started selling. Okay, meanwhile what happened means, other countries, they were also having basmati rice, especially India. So Indian people, they were restricted to sell the basmati rice because this company, it got the patent sikkitu. Hagagi other countries, especially India, it was restricted to sell the basmati rice. So idu ondu adantaddu story. Similarly, again again different attempts were made by US companies in order to get the patent for turmeric and neem. ಟರ್ಮರಿಕ್ ಮತ್ತು ನೀಮಿಗೆ ಕೂಡ ಪೇಟೆಂಟ್ ಮಾಡಲಿಕ್ಕೆ ನೋಡಿದ್ರು. ಓಕೆ, ಲೇಟರ್ ಆನ್ ದ್ಯಾಟ್ ಪೇಟೆಂಟ್ ವಾಸ್ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ಸಲ್ಡ್. ಓಕೆ, ದಟ್ ವಿಲ್ ಸಿ ಇನ್ ದ ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಕಮ್ಮಿಂಗ್ ಪಾರ್ಟ್. ಓಕೆ, ಸೊ ಐ ಥಿಂಕ್ ಇಟ್ಸ್ ಕ್ಲಿಯರ್ ವಾಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಮೆಂಟ್ ಬೈ ಪೇಟೆಂಟ್. ಪೇಟೆಂಟ್ ಮೀನ್ಸ್ ಸರ್ಟೇನ್ ರೈಟ್ಸ್ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ಗಿವನ್ ಟು ಅ ಇನ್ವೆಂಟರ್ ಆರ್ ಟು ಅ ಪರ್ಟಿಕ್ಯುಲರ್ ಕಂಪೆನಿ. Okay, for a period of time, so that company can sell, or the company can, or the inventor can fix a particular price for that. Okay. he can import it or he can export it, so others cannot import it. Athara onondeno rights annu koduvantaddu, so that is known as a patent. Next, let us see what is meant by biopiracy. 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 So biopiracy, it refers to the use of bio resources by again multinational companies and other organization without getting authorization from particular country or without paying any compensation to that particular country or the people. So that is known as a biopiracy. So it is a use of bio resources. Use of bio resources by multinational companies without any authorization or without giving compensation, without giving compensation to a particular country. Or we can say it is a one type of robbery or one type of theft. Onthara eno kallatanavannu maduvantadu, ondu tarada robbery annu maduvantadu. So especially the developing countries, they are rich in bio resources. Developing country India irbodu, Sri Lanka irbodu, okay, inta countries alli Africa irbodu, kelavondu Africa dalli kelavondu countries irbodu alli allella enagirtade, they are rich in biodiversity. Alli the biodiversity is rich. They are having different type of what? Medicinal plants irbodu, different types of organisms irbodu. Itara they are having rich biodiversity. Okay. So illi ee multinational companies, what they will do? They will what? Use those bio resources. They will use those bio resources or they will get information from the people belonging to that particular area. And they will get particular information, maybe the medicinal property of a particular plant. Itara information annu tokondu en martare, they will conduct the research and they will tell that this invention belong to us without paying any compensation to that particular country or those people. What they will do, they will what extract some products and they will tell that this belongs to us and what they want a patent sikkitu helidre further eno those developing countries they cannot sell that particular product. So ee tara ee biopiracy annu maduvantadu, that is use of bio resources by multinational companies and other organizations without getting authorization from the country and the people concerned without the compensatory payment. Okay. So without giving any compensation or without any authorization, they are what? Using those what? Bio resources. For example, the bitter gourd then the jamun jamun and the brinjal, so these plants or these fruits, they are having the anti-diabetic properties. it is used to treat the diabetes. So in our ancient Ayurveda dallella nodidre different fruits, different plants, they are used for the what? Treating different diseases. So ade tara illi ee bitter gourd irbodu, hagalakai, jamun, okay, nerala hannu irbodu, brinjal. So they are used for the what? Their anti-diabetic property in order to treat the diabetes. But some of the US companies, what they did, they took this these fruits and they extracted the substances and they told that these fruits, they are what? Having anti-diabetic properties, and they got the patent. Okay, that is few years ago this situation was there. Okay, but actually the information regarding the use of bitter gourd irbodu, jamun irbodu, brinjal irbodu, it was already recorded in some of the books such as Wealth of India. Wealth of India and Treatise of Indian Medicinal Plants. Indian Medicinal Plants. So such documents which contains the information regarding the medicinal properties of these fruits or many of the what? Medicinal plants. Okay. So later on, the Indian government, what they did means they passed a bill, that is in the parliament, regarding Indian Patent Bill. It was passed. Check the biopiracy. Okay, so second amendment act today, okay, in parliament, and this Indian Patent Bill was passed in order to check the biopiracy. Biopiracy annu check madlike ee bill annu amendment annu pass martare. So it will check the incidence of biopiracy. Okay, then so like this, the Indian government was successful in cancelling the patent which was given to Basmati rice, to rice tech company. So aa company kotta patent annu kuda cancel martare. Similarly, certain companies which are present in US and abroad, so they got the patent for what? The use of for the anti-diabetic property of the bitter gourd, jamun and brinjal. That also the patent was cancelled through this particular what? Bill. Okay, similarly one more company known as W.R. Grace company. Grace company, it also claimed the patent for the pesticide properties of a neem tree. Properties ge bekagi it claimed the patent. Usually this patent was given by what the company developed company countries such as US, Japan, avaralla en martare, they will give the or they will provide the patent, okay, for different researchers. Illi this W.R. Grace company, what they did, so this company claimed for patent for the pesticide properties of a neem tree. fungicidal as well as a pesticidal property of a neem tree. But again, the neem, it belongs to India. It is a Indian plant. Okay, it is indigenous to India. India dalli grow aguanta plant. Already the properties of neem, it is also recorded in our what, ancient books or in the Ayurveda, etc. So later on, environmentalist, that is Vandana Shiva, Vandana Shiva conducted neem campaign and finally here also the patent was cancelled. Okay, so Vandana Shiva, one of the environmental leader and a thinker, okay, involved in different environmental issues, etc. Okay, here also Vandana Shiva, due to her neem campaign, finally what happened, this patent which was given to W.R. Grace company, it was cancelled. So ee tara en martare, biopiracy is done by different countries as well as different companies. Okay, so mainly alli en madantadu, the robbery of different bioresources or the different biological products, etc., or only the informations are robbed from a particular developing countries. Okay, because they are poor, usually developing countries alli development aagta irthade agishte, and they are having what, rich biodiversity. Biodiversity tumba bio resources irthave, and they don't know to what to get the patent, etc. Okay, they are having knowledge about that, but they don't know how to get the patent, etc. They are not bothered about that. Okay, and some people for a money purpose, okay, for few money, what they will do, they will give the information to others, to other countries. Itara kuda agantadu irthade. So that is about the biopiracy. So that is about the biotechnology and its application chapter. Thank you.